Hello, everybody. This is a shout out news and thanks. I figured I should give a shout out to some games and upcoming events that look really cool to me. Yes, we are back in our Star Citizen Hangar module. I've recently upgraded to the executive Hangar module, which is surprisingly runs a lot smoother than my business class. Don't ask me why. The space is 10 times larger. It looks cooler. And it runs better. Mysteries. Mysteries abound. So yeah, I was just going to take this time to let you guys in on upcoming Kickstarters. Kickstarters past and present, in case you didn't know about them. Some really interesting games. Interesting news. Well, just news in general about maybe some Star Citizen stuff and the like. Because, yeah, I just figured, you know, it's kind of everything's kind of stagnated right now. You know, all the games have come out. It's not really anything else coming out for a while. Maybe Christmas, but everything's pretty much out, and you're pretty much playing everything that you want to play at this point. Also going to do a shout out to a YouTube user, basically a YouTube channel. I don't know if I'm going to do this as a monthly thing or weekly thing, but I figured, you know what? If this is a weekly thing or a monthly thing, I'll definitely do a shout out to a YouTube user, YouTube channel that I find hilarious. And just if nobody else knows, then there you go. So yeah, everything looks really good in the hangar. I mean, there's, you know, there's my ships. I'm really excited about Star Citizen stuff that's been happening. They have been blasting through these stretch goals like hotcakes, I would say. Just immensely quick. Let's take a quick look at that. So basically, when we hit 30 million, it was Origin 890 jump, a new ship in the works, and we just blasted through that with 31 million, and then basically just 32 and 33. They didn't even stand a chance. Those were within days, hours apart, they got destroyed. Basically, we're at the 34 million mark. Basically, the stretch goal is a miscellaneous hulls, changes out, basically just a customization for hulls for any MISC starships. And also then the 35 million is a Drake Herald, which is an information getter, which I would be super interested to see some concept art on, because that looks and sounds really cool and I'm really stoked. It's started to slow down its progress at 34 mil, but that's just because, you know, Black Friday and all. And if you guys aren't aware of the Mandate is currently on Kickstarter. It has a couple of hours left. So there's like 2 days left. Go check it out. Links in the description as always. Go check it out if you want to get your fix on some sci-fi strategy, ship building, ship customization, ship destruction, fleet management. You guys have got to go check out their Kickstarter. There's videos abound. They've even got things set up so you can make a ship, customize it, put weapons on it, and then throw boulders at it and blast lasers. The game is based on, Star Trek technology almost, in a way, where you have shields and then you have physical damage and laser damage and all that good stuff. So strongly recommend you check it out. Another Kickstarter project I strongly recommend you guys check out, and this is close to my heart because they are from South Africa, Johannesburg, and they are making this 2D isometric in the vein of, you know, Fallout and all those other good games. Just really, really good styling. It's set in the sci-fi universe and it's going to be horror. Very, very cool. Check it out. They've got some interesting stretch goals. They've got really good musical talent. Mark Morgan, if you're not familiar, there's all his list of work, and I'm sure you will like it. I'm sure you have listened to it before in your past. Lots of cool little interesting features. Reward list. They are fully backed, so thank goodness. But go check it out, and yeah, link in the description as always. If you're interested in a nice new 2D isometric game, go check out Status. They also have a YouTube channel, which I'll put in a link in the description as well. The next one I would like to see is the Stomping Land. I mean, this is long gone from Kickstarter, but I wanted to re-bring it up. Link in the description for all their websites and whatnot. Did you ever want to play, you know, as a survival game in Jurassic Park? I mean, come on, guys. there was a game out there a long time ago, if you were familiar, it was called BC. It was an alpha project. There wasn't even an actual name, but anyway, it was called BC, and it was supposed to be this. Go check it out. Really cool videos. And a little bit of Wasteland 2 news. I know they Wasteland 2 has released Wasteland 1 to play, and also Wasteland 2 is coming out in the next 2 weeks. Alpha, beta. And also EverQuest news. If you guys are interested in EverQuest Next, they're going to be releasing EverQuest Next and Landmark. Now, Landmark is a basically a building exploration voxel base, but my God, you got to check this out. It is all in-game engine. It is all in-game graphics. This is what EverQuest Next is going to look like. They currently released some packs that you can pre-purchase now, and you get all these different items. You get these different skins, you get these specialty picks, rings, plot land, like placements, flags, all this really cool stuff. And it is all persistent. Once you buy it, it is carried through every character that you own. You will not lose it. It is there. They got $99, $59, and $19. You can go look it up. Link in the description. Also, link to their YouTube channel. They got a lot of cool stuff. They do weekly updates, weekly Q&As, and sometimes they even do weekly alpha, basically, playthroughs, and they build stuff, and they show off new things. So go check it out. They got some really cool videos, and I'm just actually really interested in it. Really interested in it. And we're gonna spotlight PewDiePie. This guy's hilarious. You got to go check him out. He makes tons of videos, and just actually really good quality. Let's take a look at something. Yeah.
And welcome back to some more Dark Souls. Today is the day we're gonna champion. I read your bro's comments, and apparently you can kill the pig by a very sneaky special method, by stabbing it in the ass. Let's do it.
So there you go, everybody. That's the news for the day. And go check those things out. Links in the description. I'm going to leave you with a video that was posted on the RSR website. Just go check it out. This is awesome, awesome stuff. Just links in the description. Till next time, everybody. Have a good time. Hope you enjoyed the news update. And thanks. See you soon.